Hello everyone, today we're going to take a quick look at the BFG, based on the book of the same name written by Roald Dahl, directed by Steven Spielberg, and starring Mark Rylance and Ruby Barnhill. So there's this little girl named Sophie who is living in an orphanage in England, which is apparently just called Orphanage. Even the mail that's addressed to this place is just addressed to The Orphanage, and that's it. They're not very creative with names over there, are they? One night, she is suddenly whisked away by a giant to a mystical place called Giant Country. Fortunately, the giant in question is quite friendly, hence the title Big Friendly Giant, just in case you thought the F stood for something else. You and your dirty minds. And the BFG's job is to catch dreams and distribute these dreams to the people of England while they sleep. Unfortunately, the BFG is not the only giant in Giant Country. It wouldn't be much of a giant country if it was only one giant. No, there are many of them, and he is actually the runt of this band of giants. And the rest of them are not very friendly at all. In fact, they like to eat human beings, or human beans, as they call them. And they have names like Bone Cruncher, Maid Masher, Child Chewer, Gizzard Gulper. You know, with names like those, they could form a death metal band. Realizing the trouble these giants could cause if they were ever allowed to run amok in England, Sophie and the BFG hatch a plan to stop them once and for all. I did read the book this movie was based on way back in the day. I was probably like 10 or 11 at the time. And from what I remember, the movie is relatively faithful to Roald Dahl's story. The BFG has been brought to life with a combination of CGI and motion capture, and I thought Mark Rylance really nailed the character with his kindness and innocence and rather bizarre speech patterns. He knows what he wants to say, it just doesn't always come out right. Ruby Barnhill plays the very brave and determined little girl Sophie. I thought she was fantastic. And the design of Giant Country was very well done. It really looks like this magical, faraway place that you would find in a fairy tale. From the look of the BFG's home to the place where they catch the dreams, and even the design of the giants themselves. It is a very sweet and charming movie overall, and it's also not afraid to get dark now and then. But it doesn't get so dark that I think the younger viewers won't be able to handle it. And if you are familiar with the book, you may recall that the giant was very fond of a certain fizzy drink, which fizzed the wrong way. Instead of fizzing up, the bubbles fizzed down. And of course, after you drink something like that, there's only one place those bubbles can come out. Oh yeah, they did not shy away from that at all in this movie. There is a bit that might actually rival the famous farting scene in Blazing Saddles. It was pretty wild. Overall, I thought this movie was outstanding for the first half. Once we got into the second half, there were a few moments here and there that dragged a bit, or at least I thought they did. For example, there's a scene that's taken straight out of the book where Sophie and the BFG have breakfast with the Queen, and it's basically a one-joke sequence, and the joke is, look how friggin' huge this giant is! And that's about it. And it just goes on and on and on, and I'm thinking, okay, we get the joke, can we move on with the plot already? But for the most part, this is a pretty solid family film, and definitely deserves far more money than it's been getting. I don't even think it made $30 million in its opening weekend, which is really too bad. Not Spielberg's best work, but it is still a very solid effort from him, and I think your kids are gonna love it. At the very least, it's worth a matinee. And that's all I have to say about the BFG. Till next time, take care.